A very blessed evening, brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to our Maundy Thursday service tonight. Not forgetting those who are following us online in Facebook or on YouTube. May I invite all you to stand? Before we start our praise and worship, let's bow for a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we come before you tonight, Lord, to commemorate and to celebrate the life of Jesus some 2,000 years ago. As we remember the Last Supper with the disciples, the events that led to the betrayal in the Garden of Gethsemane, the agony and the sufferings. Tonight, Lord, as we come before you to sing, Lord, we ask, Lord, you instill in our hearts of worship, Lord, in spirit and in truth. In Jesus' most wonderful and loving name we pray. Amen. Awesome. I have found a friend in Jesus. He's everything to me. He's the fairest of thousand to my soul. He's the lily of the valley. In him alone I stand. All I need to cleanse and make fully whole. Sorrow is my comfort and trouble is my stay. He tells me every day on him to roll. It's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. It's the fairest of a thousand to my soul. He all my grief has taken and all my sorrows won. In temptation is my strong and mighty tower. I'm woeful and forsaken and all my idols gone. For my heart awake in this power. All the world forsake me and Satan tempt me to Jesus I shall safely reach the goal. It's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. It's the fairest of a thousand to my soul. He will never, never leave me, nor yet forsake me here. Hope about nothing now to fear. From his manna he might come, my hungry soldier. Then the sweet milk of Jesus is known. Then sweeping up to glory to see his blessed face, where rivers of delight shall ever roll. It's the valley of the valley, the bright and morning star. It's the fairest of a thousand to my soul. It's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. It's the fairest of a thousand to my soul. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The bread of life. I am the bread of life. He who come to me shall not hunger, and who believe in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father beckons, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. The bread that I will give, my flesh of the life of the world. And if you eat of this bread, said, you shall live forever. You shall live forever. And I will raise you up. And I will raise you up. And I will raise you up on the last day. I am the resurrection. I am the life. He who believes in me, even though he die, you shall live forever, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. Yes, Lord, I believe you are the Christ, the Son of God, who has come into the world, and I will raise you up, and I will and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. Hallelujah. Yes. Light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see beauty that makes this heart adore you. Hope of a life spent with you. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. King of all days, so highly exalted, glorious in heaven above. Humbly you came to the earth you created, all for love's sake became poor. I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. I'll never much it cost. Then my sins upon that cross, I'll never know how much it cost to see my sins upon that cross. So here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. Here together lovely, all together worthy, all together wonderful to me. Hallelujah. We want to give you, Lord, glory, oh Lord, hallelujah. Hallelujah. We praise you, Lord, but lift your name on high, oh Lord. Oh, hallelujah. We praise you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Father, we thank you, Lord, for your presence with us tonight, dear Lord. Father, even as afterwards when we listen to your words, oh Father, as delivered by our Bishop Dr. Boli, we pray, Lord, you give us an attentive heart, Lord. Anoint us, Lord, with your Spirit, Lord. We thank you and praise you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Be seated.
Let us kneel or sit to say the collect of purity this evening. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only God. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. This is the first commandment. And the second is like, namely this, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than this. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." Together, amen. Lord, have mercy, and write all these laws in our hearts, we beseech you. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. This evening, let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all men. Together, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our fellow men in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Let us say the collect of the day together. God, our Father, you have invited us to share in the supper which your Son gave to his church to proclaim his death until he comes. May he nourish us by his presence and unite us in his love, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us have the ministry of the word.
Bacaan dari Perjanjian Lama diambil dari buku Keluaran bab 12 ayat 1 sampai 14. Demikianlah firman Tuhan kepada Musa dan Harun di tanah Mesir. Bulan ini akan menjadi bulan pertama bagimu dalam setahun. Katakanlah kepada seluruh jemaah Israel demikian. Pada hari ke-10 dalam bulan ini, setiap orang hendaklah mengambil seekor anak domba menurut isi rumah kaum keluarganya, seekor anak domba untuk setiap isi rumah. Jika satu isi rumah terlalu kecil untuk menghabiskan seekor anak domba, maka bersama dengan isi rumah tetangga yang terdekat, hendaklah mengambil seekor domba menurut jumlah orang di sana. Cuba kira berapa banyak anak domba yang diperlukan memenuhi jumlah yang dapat dimakan oleh setiap orang. Hendaklah anak domba atau anak kambing itu, kamu boleh memilihnya, jantan, berumur setahun dan tiada cacat celanya. Kamu hendaklah menjaganya sampai hari ke-14 dalam bulan ini. Lalu setelah itu seluruh jemaah Israel hendaklah menyembelihnya pada waktu senja. Hendaklah darahnya diambil sedikit, lalu disapukan pada kedua-dua tiang pintu serta pada ambang setiap daun pintu rumah di mana orang memakan domba tersebut. Dagingnya yang sudah dipanggang di atas api harus dimakan mereka pada malam itu juga dengan roti yang tidak beragi serta sayur herba pahit. Janganlah makan daging itu mentah-mentah atau setelah direbus di dalam air, tetapi makanlah setelah dipanggang di atas api lengkap dengan kepala, kaki dan isi perutnya. Jangan tinggalkan sisa-sisanya sampai pagi. Kesemua sisa yang tertinggal sampai pagi hendaklah kamu bakar habis. Beginilah kamu harus memakannya, yaitu dengan pinggang berikat, kaki berkasut dan dengan tongkat di tanganmu. Kamu harus memakannya dengan terburu-buru, kerana itulah perayaan Paskah bagi Tuhan. Pada malam itu juga, aku akan melintasi tanah Mesir dan menyerang semua anak sulung di tanah Mesir, daripada anak manusia sampai anak binatang. Akan kuhukum semua tuhan sembahan warga Mesir. Akulah Tuhan. Darah itu akan menjadi tanda bagimu di rumah-rumah yang kamu diami. Apabila aku melihat darah itu, maka aku akan melalui kamu sehingga rumahmu tidak ditimpa azab kemusnahan pada waktu aku mengazabkan tanah Mesir. Hari ini akan menjadi hari yang harus kamu ingati. Kamu hendaklah merayakannya turun-temurun sebagai hari perayaan bagi Tuhan. Dan perayaan itu hendaklah menjadi ketetapan buat selama-lamanya. Inilah firman Tuhan. Terima kasih kepada Allah.
The epistle reading is taken from the epistle reading to the Corinthians, chapter 11, verses 23 to 26. For I received from the Lord what I also pass on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the gospel reading. 圣约翰福音第十三章从第一至十七节三十一节下至三十五节，愿荣耀归于基督，我们的救主。逾越节以前，耶稣知道自己离世归父的时候到了。他既然爱世间属自己的人，就爱他们到底。吃晚饭的时候，魔鬼已将卖耶稣的意思放在西门的儿子加勒人犹大心里。耶稣知道父已将万有交在他手里，却知道自己是从神出来的，又要归到神那里去，就离席站起来，脱了衣服，拿一条手巾束腰，随后把水倒在盆里，就洗门徒的脚，并用自己所梳的手巾擦干。挨到西门彼得，彼得对他说：“主啊，你洗我的脚吗？”耶稣回答说：“我所做的，你如今不知道，后来必明白。”彼得说：“你永不可洗我的脚。”耶稣说：“我若不洗你，你就与我无份了。”西门彼得说：“主啊，不但我的脚，连手和头也要洗。”耶稣说：“凡洗过澡的人，只要把脚一洗，全身就干净了。你们是干净的，然而不都是干净的。”耶稣原知道要卖他的是谁，所以说：“你们不都是干净的。”耶稣洗完了他们的脚，就穿上衣服，又坐下，对他们说：“我向你们所做的，你们明白吗？你们称呼我夫子，称呼我主，你们说的不错，我本来是。我是你们的主，你们的夫子，暂且洗你们的脚，你们也当彼此洗脚。我给你们做了榜样，叫你们照着我向你们所做的去做。我实实在在地告诉你们，仆人不能大于主人，差人也不能大于差他的人。你们既知道这事，若是去行，就有福了。”三十一节下，耶稣就说：“如今人子得了荣耀，神在人子身上也得了荣耀。神要因自己荣耀仁慈，并且要快快地荣耀他。小子们，我还有不多的时间与你们同在，后来你们要找我，但我所去的地方你们不能到。这话我曾对犹太人说过，如今也照样对你们说。我是给你们一条新命令，乃是叫你们彼此相爱。我怎样爱你们，你们也要怎样相爱。你们若有彼此相爱的心，众人因此就认出你们是我的门徒了。” This is the gospel of Christ. Praise to Christ our Lord.
We pray. Heavenly Father, help me speak and help your people hear. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Will you please be seated? Thank you for having me, especially at this time when we celebrate the Holy Week in the life of our Lord. It has been a while since I was with you. I have to say this. A retiree like me feels so honored to be invited, because that shows that you are still needed, you know. Before I go further, you know, when you are retired in the church, it is not quite the same when a teacher has retired from her school. The teacher cannot go back to the school and when the class is going on, isn't it? It's somebody else's class already. I know some of you are chigo. But the church is different. It is defined as, you know this, Father Calvin must have taught you many times. It's a family. It's God's family. In the family, nobody retires to be a member of the family. Okay, now that I have become a kake, akong, no more responsibility as when I was the head of the family. But the akong's presence in a family is special, isn't it? Oi! He remains having that respect. Yes, decisions and important things to do, rest are now rested on the shoulders of people who are at it, on Father Calvin. But Akong is still around and would be very much part of the family. And so I have been remembering all of you in my prayer throughout the diocese. When there is mourning, when there is celebrating, you can be assured that you are in my prayer. Such a family which I cherish, and one especially because I'm part of this building. I name your church Tebuan Jaya Anglican Church. I gave alternatives, which one you would choose, and you have chosen this name. The reason why we are not called a saint is this, because I gave the alternative, you can choose the traditional name, honoring a saint, or you could have it called the family of God in this place. It happened that this name was chosen. And I gave them this very humorous example in Betong. In the very remote area, they named their church after a saint, Saint Bartholomew. Nene, kake, just cannot pronounce that. And they call it Saint Miao. So they help. Even in town here, isn't it? Our seniors might not be able to pronounce difficult Western names. And so you have wisely, your pioneers wisely chosen Tebuan Jaya Anglican Church. And I'm so happy that I am part of that journey. Now, the reading this evening, you're looking at your watch. This is going to be a long haul. I am not going to go into the reading this evening. They are very appropriate, but I would just like to dwell on what is it that the church throughout the globe, the world, is celebrating. What is Monday, Thursday. And of course, with the technology, you know about it already. I'm sure you have already looked it up in your handphone. You know already. If a preacher is going to rehearse what you already read, we're not going anywhere. So I'm going to explain it in a manner that it strikes me, what it means to me, Monday, Thursday. First of all, it is a yearly celebration of the new commandment that Jesus gave to the church. That is Jesus' commandment. The giver is a gift to the people of his day. Although it was specifically to the people of his day, he said, do this forever and ever, and that includes us. Number one, this command is given by the Son of God himself to you. That's why it's very important. At the same time, he instituted, he began the Holy Eucharist. Oh, this is a very big word. Eucharist in Greek means thanks, thanksgiving. Holy Communion, also another big word. In Iban, we call it sacrament nyambut. The sacrament when we receive, isn't it? And that's simpler. But it is trying to explain that very difficult, yet very simple thing. It's a command. So, first, it is an institution of the thing that we celebrate day by day, Sunday by Sunday. And then, around that time, was it during makan, asked Father Calvin, or after makan? Jesus did a very odd thing. He went up from his seat, took a bowl of water, some towel, and washed the disciples' feet. You know that. Read your Bible. He said, do this. Love one another, this is what it should mean. Serving one another, washing one another's feet. Hey, the job of washing people's feet is not very frequently done. If it should be done, it's done by slaves. We don't have that culture. But some cultures in the world, they kneel down, they kiss the people they honor, they greet, kiss the feet. That is the most humblest thing to do. It is a complete submission, isn't it? Washing one another's feet. And this is related to the command of love your neighbor, love the family, washing one another, serving one another in a family. The weaker the member of the family, the more biased we are to help him. That's the family culture. Regardless of which religion you belong, that's how things should be. In a world where dogs eat dogs, where there are competitions, the culture of the world is this. They ignore the weak. Only the big are the big bosses. Regardless, until war going on. Yet the message of our Lord is the opposite of what the world is. He said, serve one another, love one another. This is the new commandment I give you. I'm so glad that just now we began with the summary of the commandments, the summary of the Ten Commandments. If I may summarize it even shorter, Love God, love neighbor. Then very often we forget the third implication of the Monday Thursday. It is the institution of the priesthood. This need to be unpacked. Have a Bible group and study it. What has it got to do with priests? You know, in the service of the Holy Communion, take it this in remembrance of me for the forgiveness of sins. And this is where priesthood come in. Who can forgive sins on behalf of God but the institution of priesthood? I'm going very fast here. You need a lot of unpacking. A session of one sermon mana cukup? Oi, we need to study this deeper so that it will get in, so that we understand a little of what it really means. That the command that Jesus gave, he is not giving it some 20 years ago to a congregation then isolated from us. He is giving this, pronouncing this even now. It is interesting that Jesus is urging to emphasize the commandment. He said, do it. Do it. And I'm glad as I looked up at your vision statement, you are having that very positive the way to put it, to build, to love, to make him known. And this side, I've always pointed that out to the predecessors of COVID. To take is a bit militant language, to take, to conquer. Better, don't scare people, to claim, to serve, even better. Anyway, I leave it to you to think about this. Yeah, Lawrence? But the main thing is, it's positive. When we talk about commandment, we always think about Moses one, isn't it? The Ten Commandment. You know the dominant thing about Ten Commandment? While it is of God, from God, don't know how many thousand years ago, they talk about thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not kill, don't covet, don't tell lies. You know, that's 4,000 or 5,000 years ago. You think about Borneo, Sarawak, 200 years ago, pom pom pala. Where got this ethic? Where got this moral? That associated with Moses. Don't, and thou shalt not. But the difference with our Lord is you do. Love your neighbor, love God. Chukup. Upon these two hang all the laws, all the prophets. Very positive. I'm so glad the Buandaya got it and put a very positive mission statement for your parish. Contrast of what Jesus said and what the world said. The world is saying, do not do unto others what you don't want happen to you. But Jesus turned it upside down. Do unto others what you want others done to you. You know that? Jesus, it's a very powerful message. There's a difference there. No, it's very easy to be good, you know, if you don't do. I never steal. You know the poor man at the gate of a rich man, dying of hunger. Then you know the story of the Lord Jesus. The rich man, he didn't kick out that poor man from his gate. He just wouldn't care. He regarded the poor man, the beggar, as part of the landscape. You know the story. When he died, then he realized that by not doing is not good enough. In the new commandment that Jesus is giving, it is not enough to be good by not doing anything. Do it. Do this. And Jesus emphasized this teaching by his parables. The parable of the Good Samaritan, for example. A lawyer came, you know, what's the greatest commandment? So, like he could quote easy, but he wished to justify himself. Who's my neighbor? Then the Lord Jesus telling him that parable. Then you do likewise, then and only then would you be saved. You cannot go to heaven just by being holy and do nothing. That is why our Lord keep telling his followers that they are to be the light of the world, the salt of the earth. You know what? That's what you are. There was another encounter with our Lord Jesus. One very rich man claiming that he had kept all the law. What must I do to inherit eternal life? Jesus in his teaching said, sell, serve, be part of the community. Sell all you have. So the man was very depressed after that because he had a lot of, he's a toke, big toke lah, huh? And this went on to talk about it's easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to go upstairs. Now, if I may bring you to another theme of Monday, Thursday. I know Calvin is thinking very hard at trying to nourish you in the Word, in the sacrament, and your Christian responsibility to the community. And I'm sure he is exploring what other liturgical practices in the future. What happened after Monday, during Monday, Thursday? We practice the washing of the feet. I don't know if this is ever done. Kalau ngerja to, katanya. It's a bit basah lagi and so on. So washing of the feet. It's a ritual. Because that was what Jesus did. Ritual. I know these days people are very impatient with ritual. Get on with the essence of the gospel, with the essence of the teaching. Why so much time given to rituals? I leave it to your study in the future. What does ritual mean? You know, the Jews in the ancient of days, we heard in the Old Testament reading, they practice the ritual of slaughtering a lamb on a night like this, night before the Passover, to reenact what happened when they were in Egypt, so that they remember. Another religion was inspired by this, and they call it korban, slaughter. And this is the original one, the slaughtering of the Passover lamb. It's a ritual. And Jesus was so humble that he subscribed to what his community was doing. Ritual. But the danger is, it is very easy to become superficial, to become robotic about it, like a robot. Kita buat because last time Father dulu buat, and that's not going anywhere. And that makes people who go after what's there, what's the gospel, what's the teaching, feel impatient. Let me tell you this story which I encountered. When I was Archbishop, there was never a month when I was not having a meeting overseas. Very busy. It was around Christmas time. You know, big hotel, they decorate their hotel. Put up a huge Christmas tree. You know, of course you know. Then they decorate this tree with a colored light. And this colored light got music also. And the music was playing to this jingle bell. And there were figures that ring to the tune of jingle bell, you know, Father Christmas, jingle bell. Can you imagine that? It is ringing to the tune of jingle bell. I was amazed, you know, because that one not yet coming to Sarawak yet, this colored light one. Then I saw one of the Father Christmas, he swing to ring his tune, but his bell gone already, so no noise. Jingle, he's quiet, jingle quiet. This is really strange, very funny. I think the following evening they repaired. I pointed it out to the counter. They make fun of my religion. I said, I try to be bossy a little. You see, that is robotic. Sometimes people just do the ritual, just get on with it, not knowing what behind it. That's the danger. It is better we don't do it than try to do it conjuring other meaning or make a mockery of the whole thing. Yeah? We want to do ritual, but make sure what we do really express our belief. And this ritual includes the celebration of the Holy Communion. We eat because that's what Jesus instructs us. I'm using the everyday tense. Do this in memory of me. Do this in memory of me. The old theologians think about this. We become what we eat. You think about we become what we eat scientifically. Also some truth in it, isn't it? You makan too much sugar like my cucu. It's a danger. Makan sugar. Every day 1 minute to buy sugar. It's a danger. Excessive sugar. I like Kentucky Fried Chicken. But if you're feeding on it every day, doctor is saying, hey, not very healthy, you know. You know this. We become what we eat. But there is no excess in receiving Christ in the Blessed Sacrament, I tell you. Have it as often as you can make it, because you are receiving the Son of God Himself who wish to be received, who wish to enter your life and be part of it. Not only is He commanding, giving us a new commandment, He's giving Himself. What greater gift can man receive than that? So, my takeaway, your tapao, is that there's still so much to learn from what we are celebrating and from our scripture reading this evening. But I want you to remember that Monday, Thursday speaks about a commandment, Jesus' command, that we love God, we love neighbor. That's his commandment, that he institutes the Holy Communion so that we are enabled to receive him. Not just remember a legend, a good story, happened years and years ago, but it's an everyday thing. It's a now thing. That today talks about the institution of the priesthood. Let me end with a story. This is something which I saw in my handphone. They call this, what do you call it? Then you Google it, and somehow it struck me. A very simple thing, you know. Listen, this morning I was having a breakfast with Reverend John Sim. Reverend John Sim has this sickness which many of you do not know. He is colorblind. Yeah? John Sim. Next time you meet him, ask him. Now, sometimes we take things for granted. Think about this. I'm so old already, you know. During my time, if at the camera, you it's only black and white. That's all. Still we cherish the old picture, isn't it? And that the first TV that the family had was also black and white. No complaint. I thought that's the world. Black and white is the world. Then these days, because of technology, a baby kid, a three-year-old, because of the new technology, was given a spectacle. Then he saw the world. He saw his mommy's face, a real color. Oh, I was so delighted. I cried when I saw it. And then the young man, his world was black and white. When he was given this technological spectacle, he saw the world in its full glory with all the colors. And this young man cried of delight. Then the old man, also given. The video is about people's reaction to the world as it is. My friend, sometimes we see the world as black and white only. Sometimes we see our worship as black and white only. Okay, you have good music, you're a good pastor, good preacher, but still black and white. I want you this evening, because of that command, to see that this world that Jesus loves in its full glory, you see your full color. You are surrounded by God's love. But mind you, this is not just receiving, you feel warm and toasty about it. Jesus said, the one that you need to emphasize, do it. As disciples of Jesus, as his friend, as one who receives him, we do what we can. Do it. Do this in remembrance of me. Do it. It is in doing that we are on the way with Jesus to where he brings us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let us then to say the Nicene Creed together. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate of the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Please kneel or sit for the intercession.
Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus Christ. For your grace and your mercy is always new every day. We thank you, God, that you sent Bishop Bolli to unpack the Maundy Thursday to us that our Lord Jesus is truly human and also truly divine. We pray that you continue to strengthen us in our faith in our Lord Jesus, who had died for us for our sin, who atoned us for this world and sacrificed his life for many of us who believe in him. We thank you, Lord. We praise you, Lord, that he has shown his humanity in his love for his disciples and especially the 12 chosen apostles, where it is not easy to depart with them. The passion that is shown in the Garden of Gethsemane, that the work and the character is fully shown in our Lord Jesus, that he also wanted to give his holiness, his righteousness to us. We thank you. We praise you. We also pray that through his example, we will show the glory of God to the world. We also pray for Bishop Donald Judy, that your Holy Spirit continue to guide him in the administering of the Diocese of Kuching, with all the clergy, the retired bishop, who are also in humility, serve all the rural churches, and also the laity who obediently hear the calling of our Lord Jesus, who one way or another, a simple way to serve the church, the community you emplaced each and every one of us. We also thank you, Lord, that you are able to let the scientists come up with a vaccine to combat the COVID-19, that we are able to have the endemic after 2 years and the life slowly go back to normal. But we also pray that you comfort those who lost their loved ones, who lost their jobs, who lost their security, that you continue to give them hope that only you alone can give. We also pray for those in authority, especially our state government, the federal government, their federal ministers and state ministers, that they are dispense their authority with accountability and integrity, and that the court, the judges, the civil servants, and many people who hold power or authority will also fear you, because in the end, we all have to answer to our Lord Jesus, who is the judge, a fair judge with righteousness, with justice. We also pray for Russia and Ukraine conflict, that those who instituted the conflict, especially the killing, that they too will fear you, that in the end, they have to answer to you. It's not in terms of body harm, but the soul and the spirit that you can do into their life. We also pray that you comfort those who have family members in the silent moment, name them in our heart, that you strengthen them, heal them, and also give them hope, the hope, the eternal hope that no human can give, not even doctor can give. We thank you. We praise you, Lord, for the many wonderful things that you have given to your church, your people, and also this country, our beloved country, Malaysia, that you be able to pick out from what the COVID-19 had destroyed many parts of the world, the lives, the human relationship that we are so taken for granted. So we thank you, we praise you, rejoicing in the fellowship of all our saints. We commend ourselves in the company of our Lord Jesus. Together, merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Prayer of humble access together. Most merciful Lord, your love compels us to come in. Our hands were unclean, our hearts were unprepared. We were not fit even to eat the crumbs from under your table. But you, Lord, are the God of our salvation, and share your bread with sinners. So cleanse and feed us with the precious body and blood of your Son, that he may live in us and we in him, and that we, with the whole company of Christ, may sit and eat in your kingdom. Amen. Shall we stand for the peace? Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us share with one another a sign of peace. Blessed are you, Lord God, for creation. Through your goodness, you have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God, for creation. Through your goodness, you have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. We shall use the third Eucharistic prayer. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, we give you thanks and praise. Through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Savior. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh. And as your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, was seen on earth and went about among us, he opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You may sit. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, this, your gifts of bread and wine, maybe to us, the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He gave it to them saying, he broke it and gave it to his disciples saying, take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of all men, rejoicing at his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. We bring before you this bread and this wine. We pray to you to accept this, our duty and service, a spiritual sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread, one cup, so that we in the company of all the saints may praise and glorify forever through him from all good things come, Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, honor and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. As our Savior taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ, though many we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Draw near with faith, receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. The body and the blood of Christ keep you eternal life.
Let us break bread together on our knees. Let us break bread together on our knees. When I fall down on my knees with my face to the rising sun, together on our knees. Let us drink wine together on our knees. When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, oh Lord, have mercy on me. Let us us break bread together on our knees. Let us praise God together on our knees. And I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun. Oh Lord, have mercy on me. Let us break bread together on our knees. Let us break bread together on our knees. When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, oh Lord, have mercy on me.
Shall we pray together? Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. Let us pray. Together, grant to us so to reverence the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may know within ourselves and show forth in our lives the fruit of your redemption. For you are alive and reign, now and forever. Amen. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace, and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We whom the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free. The whole earth live to praise your name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Christ crucified draw you to himself, to find in him a sure ground for faith, a firm hope, a firm support for hope, and the assurance of sins forgiven, The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Amen.
Let's be standing for the final song.
Stripping and washing of the altar. In John 13, verses 31 to 35, when he was gone, Jesus said, "Now is the Son of Man glorified, and God is glorified in him. If God is glorified in him, God will glorify the Son in himself, and will glorify him at once. My children, I will be with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and just as I told the Jews, so I tell you now, where I am going, you cannot come. A new command I give you, love one another as I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this, all men will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. The Lord be with you. O Lord Jesus Christ, who laid aside your garments in humility that we might be clothed in charity, who was hanged naked that we might put on immortality, grant us to share your blessed passion that our flesh being subdued to the spirit, we may be found worthy to appear before you, who with the Father and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns forever. One God, now and forever. Amen. We will now recite Psalms 22 responsively. My God, why have you forsaken me? Why are you so far from saving me, so far from the words of my groaning? Your turn to say it together. Yet you were enthroned as the Holy One. You are the praise of Israel. They cried to you and you were saved. In you they trusted and were not disappointed. All who see me mock me, they hurl insults, shaking their heads.
Trust in the Lord, that the Lord has saved you.
Yet you brought me out of the womb. You made me trust in you even at my mother's breast. Do not be far from me, for trouble is near, and there is no one to help.
Many fools surround me, strong fools of Russia.
Roaring lions tearing their prey, open their mouths wide against me. My strength is dried up like a potsherd, and my tongue sticks to the roof of my mouth. You lay me in the dust of death. I can count all my bones. People stare and gloat over me. But you, O Lord, be not far off. O my strength, come quickly to help me.
Deliver me from the sword, my precious life from the powers of the lions.
Rescue me from the mouth of the lions. Save me from the horns of the wild oxen. You who fear the Lord, praise him, and all you descendants of Jacob, honor him, revere him, all you descendants of Israel.
For he has not despised of his name the suffering of the wicked one. He has not hidden his face from him, but has listened to his cry of help.
From you comes the theme of my praise in the great assembly. Before those who fear you, will I fulfill my vows. All the ends of the earth will remember and turn to the Lord, and all the families of the nations will bow down before him. All the rich of the earth will feast and worship. All who go down to the dust will kneel before him, those who let him seem alive. They will proclaim the righteousness to a people yet unborn, for he has done it. The Lord be with you. O Lord Jesus Christ, who stooped to wash the feet of your disciples, that we might learn to walk in humility and love, grant that we, stripped of all pride and cleansed from all self-seeking, may in the holy sacrament of the altar be made one in you, who with the Father and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns one God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may now leave the church quietly.